So if you saw that naked photo of our BT couch before, it's all changed. Look at this. Karla Dreyer is here.
I'm so excited. Look at this.
Thanks for dressing things up.
Thank you.
This looks fantastic. A lot of textures, a lot of layers. Want to make sure you can absorb it at home. Yes, yes.
Yes. This blue couch has had a little bit of a makeover on this set. So
now, come have a seat. Tell us about the vision. I mean, it wasn't hard to top because the couch was just the couch. But how did you approach it? And if we're staging a home, that's our focus here.
Yeah. I mean, springtime is such a perfect time to sell, right? And if you're gonna sell, you wanna stage your home. And this is so huge, and you can make so much more money if your home looks good because it's such an emotional attachment. So some of the things you wanna do is clear out the clutter. And so get rid of extra books, magazines, even furniture. Like, you can rent furniture. So you could take some things away and put some things in. If you've got bookshelves, make sure that they look nice.
And we have a photo of the bookshelves.
We do have a photo. So, you know, this is my inspiration of ideally what I would love your bookshelf to look like. So I'm sure, you know, we have a lot more clutter right now. If you've got bins and baskets, you can see there at the bottom, put things in the bins and baskets. We've got the baskets on the set. So if you've got kids, throw the stuff in the baskets and get rid of that clutter. Okay. Second thing is you want to style it. And so I would say look to magazines, like home magazines, for styling. And when I say in decorating, I say sometimes don't be too perfect, but be perfect here. So you can see, like, on a coffee table, we've got the bowl and the flowers. You've got it styled up. We've got a couple pictures, I think, too.
Even in your side tables here, too.
Some side tables.
Nice.
There's some styled up coffee table action there. I think we have a kitchen picture, too. But, you know, think of these moments. You really want it to draw people in emotionally to your place. And if it's style, they can picture themselves in there.
I love your third tip, and this isn't just for home staging, because Lori is all about this. Good smells
oh,
in the place.
Oh my goodness. Well, you don't want to go in. Everyone has, like, a house smell, right? Like, yeah. I don't, you know, that was weird. But so open the windows, like, serious, like the day before, the doors, everything. Let the home breathe. Really got to breathe. Light a candle, get a nice candle, and, you know, light it in your home like an hour before, and it makes such a difference, right? I remember going into a home once and it smelled good, and it seriously made me want to buy it, because it's how you feel, and it's just creating the feeling around it.
Let's tickle the senses with some fresh flowers.
You got to have fresh flowers. I mean, bringing nature in, it makes people feel good, it makes you feel more connected, and a fresh flower. So just do something simple. Don't go crazy, but just have some fresh flowers in there. And it just makes a difference to your home and how you feel.
I like the messaging on the pillows, by the way, too. You can't see the other one. A shout out to Kitts Beach. But, oh, there's the flowers, too. But
yeah.
Vancouver. Nice
a little thing. Vancouver action. And you know what? That's another tip, is go neutral. I know we've got a blue couch, but you can see everything else we did was neutral. Because, say, you had bright green walls or bright yellow, people may not like that. So I think if you go neutral, you're appealing to more people as well.
Okay.
Yeah.
For you watching at home that have seen Karla on the show, you may not know she has a real estate background as well.
Yes.
So we wanted to say, well, what are the key questions to ask realtors to know you could trust they're the right person to make the big decision?
Yeah, absolutely. I think the first thing I would say is go with someone who knows your neighborhood, especially in Vancouver. I think there's so many pockets, to east side, to west side, to downtown. So if someone really knows your area, they're going to know what's happening there. The second thing, ask them how they're going to market it. So are they doing professional photos? Is there a virtual tour? Are they handing out flyers? Are they networking with their peers? Is it door knocking? Like, what are they going to do to market your home? And then the third thing is, get them to tell you the negatives, which sounds weird, but kind of what we were talking about here. It's like, if you need to repaint, or you need to redo that deck, or whatever you need to do, to get them to tell you the negatives so you can make your home the best you can and get the best dollar for it at the end of the day.
Final question. Can we keep this? Because this is nice.
I say yes. This looks awesome.
We can squeeze up the set. I love what you've done here. The only thing I can say is this reminds me of growing up, and maybe you at home have the same, where you have this nice, pristine room
in
your home,
and
mama always says, don't sit there.
Don't touch
this room.
Yeah, exactly. You know, I was fluffing up the pillows behind you there, right? Don't sit too far back. So, yeah, absolutely. You want your place, when you're selling it, to look its best. It's like going out on a date. You would look your best. You want your home to look its best.
Style it up.
Yeah.
We have to give a shout out to the company that helped us stage this for ideas. Where did we get the inspiration today?
It's CF Interiors, formerly known as Country Furniture.
Okay.
Yeah.
Great
ideas.
We've
got some great stuff there. So,
Karla, thank you.
Thank you.
Now, can we just lounge back?
We can lounge now. We can mess up the pillows. It's okay.
We'll enjoy the good life over here. Listen, we'll take a quick break. Follow along on social media.